Okay, guys, so we're talking about perfected love this week, okay? And we found out yesterday in relationship to chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians, that's the love chapter. But the love chapter is in reference to the gifts of the Spirit in chapter 12. And when love is perfected, when love matures, when we grow up into Christ, then the gifts of the Spirit begin to flow through us freely. Again, it says, when that which is perfect comes, then we'll be able to see clearly. Okay, perfected love, because it's talking about about love right there, okay? I want to show you something. Turn with me to 1 Corinthians again, but this time let's go to chapter 1. Now, I taught this quite probably about 2 years ago on Tack Room Devotional, so but taught it a little bit different, so please follow with me. Let's pick up with 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 21. It says, "For since in the wisdom of God, the world through wisdom did not know God, it pleased God through the foolishness of the message preached to save those who believe." Now, again, notice this. It says, the world through wisdom did not know God. So, in other words, the wisdom of the world doesn't allow us to know God. And it says, the foolishness of the message, people get saved. In other words, once again, if we don't understand God for who He is, if we try to make Him like us, if we try to reason things out based upon who we are, you'll never get it. Remember, His ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. As a matter of fact, it even says here, it says that He takes, because the foolishness of God is, this is verse 25, because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. So you see, the wisdom of God is different. And the strength of God is different than we understand it. So we need to see it spiritually. That's why it's so important to learn about this perfected love, because we're going to be able to see it better, okay? Let's read on. It says, "For Jews request a sign, and the Greeks seek after wisdom." So again, the Jews said, hey, if you want us to believe, show us a sign. The Greeks, they were really into the intellect, so they wanted wisdom. But look what it goes on, verse 23, and it says, "But we preach Christ." What does Paul preach? He said, "We preach Christ, Christ crucified." Okay? To the Jews, it's a stumbling block, and to the Gentiles, or to the Greek, it's foolishness. But to those who are called, that's us, to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ is the power of God and the wisdom of God. Okay, now we've talked about this before. Christ is not Jesus' last name. His mother was not Mary Christ. His father was not Joseph Christ. Christ speaks of the anointing. Christ means anointed, anointed one. So Jesus Christ, it means Jesus the anointed one. And we've taught this before, so I'm not going to go back. But Jesus says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because He's anointed me to preach the gospel of the poor, set at liberty those who are in captivity, heal the brokenhearted," and so forth. That's in Luke chapter 4. So the anointing, okay, so here it says Christ, which again is not His last name, it's called the Anointed One, or here it's speaking of the anointing, Christ is the power of God and the wisdom of God. Okay, make sure you get this. I know this is, I'm cramming a lot in 5 minutes, but listen to me. So Christ, the anointing, is the wisdom of God and the power of God. Now you're called a Christian. Why? Because you're supposed to act and look and do the things that Jesus did. He has placed His mantle of anointing on you and I and told us to go and do the same things He did, and greater works shall we do because He went to be with the Father, right? So we have this anointing. We have the authority over all the power of the enemy because of this anointing that's on us that Jesus gave us. What does that mean? It means the anointing is the wisdom of God and the power of God. Now, you may not believe you have the wisdom of God and the power of God, but I'm telling you right now, you're a Christian. You're the body of Christ. You're the bride of Christ. You have the mind of Christ. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Now, All of those you can substitute. When you say Christ, you can substitute the wisdom and power of God. So you can say, I have the mind of the wisdom and power of God. I'm the body of the wisdom and power of God. I'm the bride of the wisdom and power of God. I can do all things through the wisdom and power of God. You see, all of that is, you can fit in there. Now here's one last thing. In 1 John, several places, it tells us that God is love. So now let's substitute God, because he is love, let's substitute love. So Christ is the wisdom and power of love. And we're talking about God's kind of love. Christ is the wisdom and power of love. Now I want you to think about that. We're going to pick this up again tomorrow right here. Say it again. Christ is the wisdom and power of love. I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. I love you. Jesus loves you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek him and serve him.